finally arrived. What do you think? Doesn't just feel like a real courtroom. It's like a Hollywood movie set, right?
Feels like a Star Chamber Inquisition.
Yeah, he said Inquisition. Not even close, it's total shit. Well, okay, everyone find your assigned seats and sit down. Yee-hoo! They don't even sit, they stand the whole time. Hurry up now, hurry up. We did what he said and found our seats.
I wouldn't call it a seat, but...
Yes, they're standing the whole time. The seats were arranged in a giant circle. It was set up so that everyone could see everyone else, which also meant it'd be easy for anyone to transfer their tension and unease onto anyone else. The air seemed to grow heavy as we sat there. And so, the curtain in our first case opened. A deadly judgment, a deadly deception, a deadly betrayal. A deadly riddle, deadly defense, deadly faith, deadly clash trial. Here, if we did the free time events, we would have been able to acquire skills that would make give it more advantages to like the trial, make it easier. Yeah. But there's nothing else really, so just finish preparations.
Let's begin with a basic explanation of the class trial. So, your votes will determine the results.
Like I said.
If you can figure out who done it, then only they will receive punishment. But if you pick the wrong one, then I'll punish everyone besides the blackened, and the one that deceived everyone else will graduate.
And the killer really is one of us, right?
Is her face with an X on it?
Of course!
Yep. Yeah, it does. They talk about that later.
Okay then, everyone close your eyes, and whoever did it, raise your hand!
Don't be a goddamn idiot. Why the hell would they raise their hand?
Before we move on and start the trial, can I ask a question real quick?
I'd feel awful if they got left out just because they died! Friendship penetrates even death's barrier.
Yeah.
Friendship penetrates?
No, Ufumi, do not.
But what about that other empty seat? There were only 15 of us to begin with, so why are there 16 seats?
Oh, no reason. It's just that our little courtroom here can technically fit up to 16 people. Okay. That about does it for the preamble. Get ready to get started. First up is the case summary. Now, let the class trial begin.
It's about to begin, the debate to decide who we think the killer is.
The fate of the world.
Anything I found, anything I noticed, I have to be ready to speak up about everything. Because this isn't just about me. Everyone's lives are on the line. First non-stop debate. Okay, I can explain it or you can let them explain it. Your choice.
You explain it.
Okay, a non-stop debate is basically everyone argues back and forth constantly and it throws up words on the screen and you can move the cursor around. At points there will be weak spots that are bolded yellow and you're able to take your truth bullets or evidence and cycle through them and choose them, use it to shoot at one of those weak points to find contradictions.
Cute.
They make it pretty simple early on. Only one truth bullet.
I assert that the one who was murdered was Miss Sayaka Maizono!
Of course you know that part already. And the murder took place in Makoto's room.
In the bathroom. So it seems most likely that the killer must have taken her by surprise while she was in the bathroom. She didn't even have a chance to resist.
That would be a weak point.
What do I hit to do?
Yeah. That's important. Okay. For one, I'm pretty sure select. No, not select. Maybe it was. Nope.
I assert that the one who was murdered was
Triangle
Ms.
to shoot it, but I'm trying to remember.
Yeah, you know that part already.
You can use this to slow down, but it uses up that
and
one gauge.
The murder took place in Makoto's room.
In the back.
I don't remember.
Triangle to shoot.
Triangle to shoot. Yeah. Oh no! You press. You press start. It brings up this, and if you press R, it shows you controls.
She was in the bathroom. She didn't even have a chance to resist.
You have to put it on the.
Wait.
You aim. You were like well above it. You have to put it on the actual letters. And you can fast forward with.
Yeah, you know that part.
Oh, do you have a time limit?
And the murder
technically, but it's really high. Fast forward with. Circle. And you go down, and then you put it over it, and then.
I kept hitting the button.
You were too late.
I assert that the one who was murdered was Miss Sonic.
And you can fast forward a
second. Yeah, we know that the murder took place in the
I'm gonna fail.
You have.
The killer must have taken her by surprise while she was
no,
in the
it's,
bathroom.
Oh, you can only shoot the yellow ones.
She didn't even have a chance to resist.
Why are you not doing anything?
I don't know what the heck I'm doing.
It's really not.
Always wrecked.
The killer must have taken her by surprise while she was in the bathroom.
You simply shoot
she didn't even have a chance
at weak points like that if you think that they're contradictions.
You do it.
Oh my goodness.
I assert that the one who was murdered can't know that the murder took place in the bathroom.
So the killer must have taken her by surprise while she didn't even have a chance to resist.
I was too low, but.
I assert that the one
who was murdered was
okay.
Murder.
Pay attention. It's as simple as. And if you need more time, you can slow down time.
Oh, you have to shoot it at the actual phrase?
Yes.
No, that's wrong.
That's the point. At a point, like, stuff comes up and.
Just a second, Chihiro.
You have to.
Try to remember how my room looked. With the way things had been damaged. I think we can definitely assume there was a struggle.
Oh, wait. Oh, wait. I forgot something. Who do you think did it?
I think I kind of vaguely went over that.
I don't remember.
I basically said, Hitler Youth is still my best guess. That being said, I'm not as convinced as I was in the beginning. I guess if I had to have a secondary, you know, I could say Fatty did it. And I could also say, would be tertiary, would be the third.
Tertiary?
Yeah, I think that's for third, like, it's like secondary, basically.
Who?
It's primary, secondary, tertiary.
Oh, I thought you were, like, referring to someone as tertiary.
No.
I was like, that's an interesting nickname.
So tertiary would probably be, swimsuit. Or Hina.
Between who and who?
Between Sayaka and the killer, of course.
So you're saying Sayaka wasn't caught by surprise in the bathroom?
She must have been attacked in the main room first. Then she ran to the bathroom to try and hide.
If you don't wanna...
The killer followed her in, and that's where they finished the job.
It auto-progresses it.
That much should have been obvious after taking one look at the scene. It shouldn't even need explaining.
Sorry.
Okay, so what's next?
Next is the subject of the murder weapon.
You can hear it real.
This is starting to sound like a real trial.
We need to determine what was used to kill Sayaka. Okay, that does give me plenty of time to say his inner thoughts. Okay, that's good. Kitchen knife set.
Yeah, they do make it pretty easy this first one.
Oh yeah, it's like halfway through the game they stop really introducing stuff.
There was some kind of sharp object thrust into her stomach. Without a doubt, that is the murder weapon.
Shocking.
So the killer used some random knife they had on him. How could anyone do something like that? Son of a bitch.
Okay, now you can fast forward with circle back up to that point, and you can press button to slow it down if you need more time, or if you want to make sure you hit it. It also steadies your aim a bit.
Some random knife they.
No, that's wrong.
It's dramatic.
Oh yeah, it's hype. So much hype.
No. I do think it was a knife, but not just any knife. I'm almost positive it was a kitchen knife.
Huh? A kitchen knife?
After the murder, we discovered that one of the knives from the kitchen was missing.
Which means that knife must be the murder weapon.
Oh, yeah. I guess that makes sense. You could sort of see the weapon sticking out of her stomach. And if you look real close, I could totally see that being a kitchen knife.
Okay, so the murder weapon was a kitchen knife, but where does that get us?
Well, I mean,
we all know Makoto killed her, right?
That's right. Makoto's room was the scene of the crime. What more proof do you need?
Hold on a second.
Let's draw our conclusions after we presented our arguments. Otherwise, what's the point of the trial?
Well, we can talk all we want. It's not going to change that conclusion.
I don't think that's true at all. I'm sure if we keep at it, something new will reveal itself.
You really believe that?
He's right. There's got to be a breakthrough somewhere just waiting for us to find it. Because I know damn well I'm not her killer. I have no idea what they're introducing. Concentrate. Okay, so basically this thing I was telling you. It'll use up the focus gaze, but if you hold R, you can slow down time, basically. But it uses up the green gauge up top, which is the focus gauge. While the blue gauge is your influence gauge, which basically if you get things wrong, then the blue one is focus.
But where does that get us?
Makoto must have taken it from the kitchen, right? He did it in secret.
No, that's wrong!
I still think that's funny.
No, that's wrong.
Yeah.
Okay, wait. Hold on. I didn't take the knife from the kitchen.
Next, you're gonna say you're not the killer, right? Go ahead and say it all you want.
Well, what if I have a witness? What do you think, Hina?
Huh?
Remember what you were telling me earlier?
Well, I went to go get some tea.
No, these are flashbacks.
Oh, so I don't need a voice.
Don't bother. Just get past them. We know what happened. If you don't know what happened and you've been watching this, then...
Just to be perfectly clear...
I'm sorry.
The knife disappeared while you were in the dining hall, correct?
Yeah, that's right.
And at any point while you were there, did you ever see me come into the dining hall?
No, I don't think so.
You don't think so?
No, he definitely wasn't there.
The knife disappeared while Hina was in the dining hall. But I wasn't there the entire time. In other words, there's no way I could have taken the knife.
Okay, then what about this? What if the idiot swimmer girl and Makoto are in on it together, and lying to protect each other?
What if?
Idiot swimmer girl? Oh, and more importantly, why would I get involved in something like that?
Speaking of which, I'd like to ask the bear, if there is an accomplice, do they also become blackened?
So you ask, and so I shall answer. Each murder is allowed to have an accomplice, but only the one who does the killing will get to graduate.
So in other words, two people can work together, but one of them has no chance of profiting from it.
Then there's no way anyone would work together, right?
But what if they did work together, and they just didn't know about the rule?
Good grief! Enough already! No, okay? There are no accomplices in this case!
Oops! Did I say that out loud?
Anyway, I didn't go to the dining hall, and I didn't take the knife. So I'm not the killer!
Okay, so then, who did take the knife?
Hina seems the obvious candidate. After all, she just said she was in the dining hall.
No way!
I swear it wasn't me!
Sure, but can you or Fanny anyone else it. Prove that?
I can.
That's right. Sakura was with me the entire time I was drinking my tea.
I hate to have to ask, but just to be sure, Sakura's...
me.
Right.
But then, couldn't either one of them have grabbed the knife?
Actually, no. Because, well...
Just spit it out already.
I stayed in Hina's room last night.
I got so scared thanks to those creepy videos. I wasn't really thinking, I just asked her to stay over.
And have lesbian sex.
Which means we have airtight alibis.
Maybe,
you
I don't know.
Stayed over? Doesn't that violate one of the school regulations?
We're not allowed to sleep anywhere but the dorms. But it doesn't say we have to stay in our assigned room. So, I don't think that's a problem.
It is a problem! A boy and a girl spending the night together? It's unwholesome!
But I'm a girl.
What? You are? Oh my gosh, I'm so sorry!
Well, it wasn't either of you.
Taka.
What other possibility is there?
Actually, there is one other possibility. Right, Hina?
Oh, yeah, that's true! One other person did come to the dining hall while we were there.
Why didn't you say so in the first place?
Well, because... they're not here anymore.
What do you mean by that? Someone who's not here? Are you talking about...
Sayaka?
Junko? No, Sayaka.
She's the one who came to the dining hall.
Oh.
And then later, she wound up dead.
Sayaka? Okay, so here's another thing. So, you have a minute to figure out. So, the person who took the knife from the kitchen was... Monokuma!
Was it?
No.
Sayaka?
Your choice.
I got it!
And that means you got it right.
Sayaka is the one who took the knife?
That's the only possibility. And thinking back on it, she was acting kind of unusual. When she came into the dining hall, she didn't even look at us. She just went straight to the kitchen. As she left, she said she just wanted a drink of water. But most likely...
Then the person who took the knife was the victim herself.
I'm sure she just took it for self-defense.
So you're saying the knife she took was then taken from her, and she was killed with it?
In was she
case,
planning on...
You may not have taken the knife,
maybe she was planning
but you
on
still
killing
could
Makoto.
Have killed her.
You think she might have been planning
what?
To kill Makoto?
Maybe.
See? He did do it after all!
No! You're wrong!
So, that's how you would twist the argument and send us all off in the wrong direction? You possess a most terrifying talent.
Damn, if I don't do something, they're gonna blame me for the murder. They understand? If they convict me, everyone's gonna die.
Hold on. It's still too early to decide conclusively that Makoto is the killer, wouldn't you say?
No!
Because you see, if the room did belong to the killer, then they did something most bewildering. And until we unravel that little mystery, you simply can't declare that he's the killer.
Bewildering? What the hell are you talking about?
Something was missing from the scene of the crime that by all rights should have been there. You know what I'm talking about, don't you?
Hangman's Gambit. Okay. Probably the stupidest thing in either game. But not at all. It's fill in the blank. Something that shouldn't have been there unless my crucial point. Go on. Yep. It's simulating the idea of thinking up of a word. It's quite literally fill in the blank.
There's no carrot, right?
Yep. Now pick the letters in order. Yep, you need to hit them multiple times until they go away.
Yeah. That was pretty stupid.
Yeah, and they make it even fucking worse in the second game by actually giving it difficulty.
Right. There wasn't a single hair on the floor.
So, the culprit removed some evidence?
Yes. And if I were the culprit, why would I need to get rid of all the hair in my own room? It wouldn't be unusual at all to find my hair at the crime scene if the crime scene is in my room.
The reason all the hair was gone was to remove any trace that Sayaka had ever been.
Except she died there.
That makes sense, does it not?
No. If that were the case, they would have had to do something about the body itself, not just her hair.
Not to mention the whole struggle thing.
Yes, yeah. Very true, very true.
Okay, then why wasn't there any hair on the ground?
The killer got rid of it all, of course, to remove any trace that they had ever been there.
Wait, then that means...
Precisely. It's simply beyond reason to believe that the room's owner and the killer are one and the same.
Then Makoto isn't the culprit.
God, it just fucking
sure
hit them.
Are you decide something so important based solely on the absence of some hair?
What are you worried about, bro?
There are other reasons that prove why Makoto couldn't have done it.
I would like to hear these reasons.
Do you remember anything remarkable about the bathroom at the scene? Sayaka was attacked in the main room first, then fled into the bathroom, right?
Yeah, then they ran after her, got into the bathroom, and stabbed her.
And how did the killer get into the bathroom? Did they have any trouble with it?
What do you mean?
I mean how it's the lock was broken?
The killer had some trouble getting
basically
into the bathroom.
What she's saying is because if they knew if it was him, he would have known how to open the door.
Do you remember, Makoto?
He wouldn't have needed to unhinge it.
Killer struggled getting into the bathroom, and the evidence that proves it is just pick the evidence that proves it. It should be obvious based on the picture. It's the doorknob stuff.
Oh yeah,
not that one, not that one. Doorknob there. Triangle.
I got it. Evidence that the killer had trouble getting into the bathroom.
Part of the problem with this is that you just want to watch it, and you don't really want to participate.
The doorknob? What doorknob?
The doorknob for my bathroom.
I find
it
very,
completely broken.
Very fun to be actively
see
participating
how the top part was
in
unscrewed,
the trying to figure out
and the doorknob's
stuff.
About ready to fall off?
Oh yeah, true. But what does it mean?
In trying to bypass the lock, they ended up nearly removing the entire doorknob. This is another most bewildering act for the room's owner. It proves Makoto is beyond suspicion.
So what? You're saying he wouldn't break the door in his own room? But if the only choice you have is to break it, you break it. There's nothing bewildering about it.
You still don't see? Okay then. Let's take another look at how the incident unfolded. Hopefully that will help you understand.
She's definitely on her side.
Kyoko said it was a bewildering act. I almost didn't notice it at first, but is that the key point here? Probably. If something else comes up, that's not something I've told you. So the hearts are your influence, which goes out, means you lose, game over. And it goes down when you mess up. The focus gauge shows how much time you can slow down, and that's the blue.
The incident took place in Makoto's room. Sayaka was first attacked in the main room.
And you messed up.
Oh, I did.
There can be... they're probably saying that there can be multiple weak points now. That's probably what that tutorial was about. You have to choose, because not all weak points are stuff... are actually contradictions.
Sayaka was first attacked in the main room. She then fled into the bathroom.
Think about what the weak point actually says.
Then the killer sorry, I didn't know there was going to be more than one.
Right.
And they got into the bathroom.
No, it's not the end of the world.
At that point, the killer had to try and bust down the door. Because Sayaka had locked it.
No, that's wrong! The reason my bathroom didn't open wasn't because it was locked. After all, the girls' rooms are the only ones with locking bathrooms, right?
Unless his room's actually a girl's room.
Now that you mention it, that is true.
Then why didn't the bathroom door open?
You know what? We never checked that.
Huh? What are you talking about? My bathroom door doesn't fit in the frame quite right. Monokuma over there can testify to that.
Yep. True as true can be.
Oh, thank you, Monokuma.
You're supposed to be the ultimate lucky student, right? But to have such a cruddy door... that's not lucky at all!
So the reason the door didn't open was just because
it was
stuck.
Just ignore him.
But the killer didn't know that and assumed it was locked. So they tore apart the doorknob to get in.
Okay, but then why would the killer even think the door was locked in the first place? Everyone should have known you can't lock any of the boys' bathrooms.
The killer could easily make that mistake, thanks to one important detail about the scene of the crime.
What might that be? One important detail. Something the killer did not know. For some reason, they were convinced the door was locked. Which means the important detail the killer didn't know. What did they not know? Between these two. Well, only one of these is true in the first place, so.
Yeah.
I got it!
I don't know.
The killer must not have realized that it was my room.
What? Are you saying the culprit didn't even know where he was?
Well, they're still piecing together events. They really haven't done much to point towards a killer person yet.
Say what?
Well, to be more specific, what the killer didn't know was that Makoto and Sayaka had switched rooms.
Fumi's a bit
which
eccentric.
Is what led to the misunderstanding about the bathroom. If Sayaka had been in her own room, then...
Then there would have been a lock on the door, and they would have had to break through!
So they had no idea how unnecessary their actions were.
Ultimately, we can't know if it came open by force or simply by accident, but the killer must have been considerably confused, with no idea how they actually got the door opened.
Regardless, it was a pointless act. Wasting time trying to break down a door that wasn't locked is
pretty
funny.
Definitely something I wouldn't do, since I would have known exactly why it wasn't opening, right?
That is a definite possibility.
So the killer
doesn't
want to
admit
to be someone who didn't know they'd switched rooms?
Then Makoto couldn't have done
it. Oh my god, he's admitting it!
Well, even she.
Okay, then
even
who did
she has
it?
Enough common sense to
I'm
turn
sorry,
around at a point.
I give up! Quit without saving!
But what happens if we can't decide on who we think did it?
Well, why don't we just vote right now? Majority rules!
Majority rules? Do you really think that's a good idea?
Yeah, our necks are on the line here.
Okay,
someone seriously
if
needs to
Hiro
do something,
says it's stupid, it's
serious.
Probably really fucking
does no
stupid.
Does no one have any other thoughts or questions? It does not matter how trivial they may seem.
Oh, as a matter of fact, I do have one question.
Oh, you...
You don't want to sound so disappointed.
It's fine, it's fine. Just ask your question.
Oh, yeah. Okay, so, well, I was just wondering, how did the culprit get into Makoto's room in the first place?
Good question.
Yes. How did the killer
Speak
get
up.
Inside?
That's a good question.
Maybe Sayaka just dropped the key somewhere and the culprit picked it up. That's possible, right?
I don't think so. That seems way too convenient.
Then, maybe someone picked the lock?
Negative! If you remember, Monokuma made it quite clear that the locks are all unpickable.
Fine. How about this? The killer got in the easy way. They could have knocked and said they wanted to talk or something, and Ms. Maizono just let him
no.
in.
No, that can't be it either.
Uh-huh.
Why not?
Trying to
well, because she was like, I'm
me?
Not gonna open it for anybody
Sounds
besides
like
you.
Someone
not
know
even
his place.
Yeah.
Hello? Why exactly can't that be it?
Reasons there's no way is, well, I think we talked about that briefly. I'm not entirely sure what evidence... Oh, switching rooms. Oh, you already passed it.
I'm just looking at the rest to make sure.
I got it! Because Sayaka was already scared, remember? That's why she asked me to switch rooms in the first place.
You can probably skip past this. Just... We know what happened.
Knowing what she'd been through, I just can't believe she would have opened the door for anyone.
What if her being scared was a lie?
Huh?
Well, she did go downstairs.
What the hell is that supposed to mean?
With the knife.
Why would she lie Same about floor, something like that?
Okay.
I know you don't want to consider it, but look at this and tell me. Can you still deny the possibility?
There's something I want to talk to you about, just us two. In 5 minutes, come see me in my room. Check the nameplates to make sure you don't get the wrong room, okay?
I found a notepad during my search, and I shaded in the top sheet with a pencil. And these are the words that appear.
Oh man! I've totally seen people do that on detective shows! When you write, it can leave an imprint! Sketch over the next sheet of paper, and you can see the words! When I saw that, I was like, holy crap! I better make sure I rip the paper out before I use it from now on.
Oh, you totally didn't do it right.
It's a pretty old-fashioned technique. But even the classics can be surprisingly useful sometimes. Oh, and I should also mention, I found the notepad on the desk in Makoto's room.
Huh?
Which means, only someone who had been in Makoto's room before the incident could have written it.
Then either it was Makoto who lived there, or Sayaka who switched rooms for a single night.
So, Makoto, did you write this?
No, I didn't. But...
Of course you didn't. Because the note also bears a perfectly legible signature. Sayaka's signature.
And that note... Sayaka wrote it?
But why? Why would she write that?
The note was likely her way of getting in touch with a certain someone. She must have slid it under their door to let them know she wanted to meet with them in secret.
That person probably killed him.
You got an invitation like that from the ultimate pop sensation. What young man could resist?
Of course, I'm only into 2D, so it wouldn't have any effect on me.
But can we be sure anyone even got this note?
I hope he did.
And honestly, even if they did, I do not think they are at all involved in what happened.
Huh? What makes you say that?
Would you like to hear what I have to say?
Yes, just say it.
Well then, pay attention.
Yes, just say it. Oh, well, okay, they were introducing this.
Sayaka and Makoto switched rooms, correct? But in the note,
correct.
The place they were asked to come to, it specifically says, my room.
I see. So if someone read that note, then they would have gone to Sayaka's room.
Exactly. The room that Makoto was staying in. So in other words, even if someone did read the note and did what it said, they would not have any connection to what happened.
It certainly would seem that way.
Alright.
So what did I...
Huh? Well, it didn't hurt you, so it means you missed it.
Which one? But in the
they
note,
did switch rooms,
the
door...
they were asked to come to, it specifically says, my room.
I see.
Right, it did say
so
that.
So if someone read that note, then they would have gone to Sayaka's room.
Exactly. The room that
probably that. Yep.
No, it's wrong.
Because...
I'm like half awake, just to be honest. It is late.
The nameplates on Mai and Sayaka's rooms got switched.
They got switched?
That's right. The nameplates got switched, just like the rooms themselves.
I love her. She'll probably kill someone eventually.
The nameplate on Sayaka's
she seems like she'd be good at getting away with it.
Name.
She hasn't killed this person, otherwise she wouldn't be trying so hard. But she would have don't blame on to Makoto. They were all ready to convict
her. Actually marked as her room.
Then, if someone did do what the note said, they would end up at Makoto's room where Sayaka was.
Plus, their rooms are right next to each other. So switching the nameplates would be no problem.
A pretty popular character.
And the one who switched the name
and I'm gonna
was...
leave it at that.
Well, of course it wasn't you.
She'll
right,
kill
Makoto.
Someone eventually.
Right?
It'll be towards the end.
Okay, then who did it?
There's only one person who could have switched the nameplates. Killer, Makoto, or Sayaka.
Well, it's either Kayoka or Sayaka.
Sorry?
It's either, sorry, the killer or Sayaka.
Okay.
It's the killer. Yeah.
Who do you think did it?
The killer.
Killer had to be the one to switch it. I'm sorry to burst your bubble, but they had no idea you were actually in your room, right? So the only person that could have switched it was... Sayaka.
Me and Sayaka were the only ones who ever knew about us switching rooms. So the only other person besides me who would even know to switch the nameplates was Sayaka.
You can also infer as much from her note.
Something I want to talk to you about, just us two, 5 minutes, come see me.
Yeah, I gotta think that she was planning to kill someone. And
she
it backfired.
Specifically tells the reader to check the name.
It was probably Makoto.
She would only
if it was Makoto,
that, she knew the name
then why didn't Makoto get that message?
No, she was probably planning to
but
kill Makoto.
Why would she switch them in the first place?
Why is that message there then?
She wanted someone to
come
to the room
someone
she was
to
in.
Do it.
And also
so she wanted to get
Makoto's
an accomplice
room.
To kill Makoto.
Yeah.
What?
Inviting someone to your room, but not telling them you'd switched rooms. Why would anyone do that?
To understand that, we first need to understand what happened after she invited the person into the room. That's where the answer lies.
What happened then was probably whoever she invited over came in and attacked her. We figured it out. We know who did it. Whoever she invited over is the culprit.
No shit, Sherlock.
We still don't know who it is, you goddamn idiot.
Sayaka fought with her killer there in the room, yes? Perhaps the answer to our previous question lies in that initial struggle.
Yes, I think you're right.
Then... we just have to figure out what happened during the fight, right?
That reminds me. There was a replica sword at the murder
scene. I love her.
There are some very intelligent people in this group.
Oh,
did
yeah.
I mention that?
What's the deal with that sword?
Some really stupid
Sayaka
ones.
Sayaka suggested I should hold on to it.
Yep.
I thought it might come
Kyoko
in handy
probably
if I
the
had
stupidest.
To defend myself. It
Kyoko
seems
is
pretty
not
likely
very smart
that
either.
The killer used it to break Sayaka's right wrist.
Thank goodness
How
we have
the hell
Hiro.
Could he possibly know that's what broke her wrist?
Because he's the, you know, he's our only hope for getting out of this.
No. Presumably, you'd know it happened to the wrist because...
Sayaka's wrist?
Presumably. Yep.
I got it! All you have to do is take a good look at her broken wrist, and it should become pretty clear. Right there where her wrist is all swollen.
Dropping truth on y'all.
There's something blurry there. See?
Truth bullets.
Is that gold? Mm.
How'd you like me to unload my
it
truth
sure
bullet
is.
Into you?
Specifically, boom. The gold coating from
is that
the
what
replica
Aces says?
Sword. You barely have to touch that stuff.
That's dark.
And it'll stick.
That is dark.
Well, it was just
some
dropped.
On her wrist because...
I got it! Because she got hit with the sword! Right there on her wrist!
I
wonder if you survive an attack, if Monokumo will provide you with medical
right,
services.
Then it's about time to solve this mystery.
Or you'll just be crippled for the rest of your time there.
I don't... I know in the second game that comes up, and he does. I'm not sure there's an example here.
Oh, wait, what?
Okay, so I'm assuming they're introducing multiple truth bullets.
When the fighting broke out,
so you hold in this, and you can choose between the evidence. And if you want to read what they are, you can press that and look at the truth bullets.
Okay, which ones were they?
So the replica sword sheath, kitchen knife set, and the replica sword. If you feel you need to look at the details on those, feel free.
She grabbed the kitchen knife she had hidden away. But then the culprit took that from her too.
And they killed her with it.
And that's exactly what happened.
So, where might the issue lie?
The sword was used for...
What was used for?
Oh yeah, this...
When the fighting broke out, the culprit grabbed the sword. And that's when the first blow was dealt. The sword-based sneak attack!
No, that's wrong!
Oh, I got it.
Was that a guess?
No.
Well, why do you think that was true, then?
Because she's talking about the order of the sword.
Started with the sword.
Like, because the sword the sheath clearly, so she clearly just panicked, went for scratched. It. Hit him with the sheath,
see?
Just a panic.
There's a gash in it, like someone cut into it with something sharp.
Something sharp? You mean like the kitchen knife? That was the only sharp thing found at the scene.
Stop jumping ahead. Slow down and explain it so I get what the hell's going on.
If the sword was used first, there wouldn't
be any
explanation for the scratch on the sheath. If you were going to attack with the sword, you'd take it out of the sheath first, right?
That's true. With the sheath on, it'd be heavy and bulky and useless as shit.
Okay, so how did the sheath get damaged?
If they got attacked with the kitchen knife, maybe they grabbed the sword as a defensive impulse. In that situation, there wouldn't be any time to actually unsheath the sword.
So you're saying the sword was initially used to defend against an attack from the knife? Which means whoever had the kitchen knife was the one who attacked first!
I think I get it! So here's how it all played out. The culprit came in, found the kitchen knife hidden there somewhere. Then they took the knife and attacked Sayaka before she knew what was happening. So she grabbed the sword to defend herself, but then the culprit took that from her too. Then, after they broke her wrist with the sword, they took the knife and finished it.
Sorry, but I don't think Sayaka used the sword to defend herself.
What? How the hell can you not think that?
Because she never held the sword at all. There's a certain part of her body that
makes this. Oh, someone took it
and
that's what the broken wrist is from.
Someone else used it to hit her wrist?
Yeah.
Palms. It's palms.
I got it!
It's proving that she didn't hold it.
You're talking about her palms, right? The palms of her hands were perfectly clean, so I don't think she ever picked up the sword.
How can you know that just by looking at her palms?
Like I said before, the gold coating on that sword comes right off. All you have to do is touch it.
Honestly, it makes it a really shit sword.
You'll notice that a lot of the gold has already come off the handle. It's safe to assume that's because whoever used the sword got some of it on their hands. There's really no way she could have picked it up and come away completely.
Sorry, part of this is I have to watch it and process it, and it makes it very hard to regularly comment. I miss stuff when I do.
Sorry, but I don't think so.
Be impulsive.
Why do you say that? Is it because you think I'm ugly?
You want to turn?
Yes, you are actually ugly. No one loves you. Your parents.
If you really want to, you could turn it off auto and make comments.
There's no way Sayaka washed the gold because.
She's afraid of water!
Ah. Oh, because the water was off.
Yeah.
I got it!
Now, if you want to stop it while you're processing stuff, you could turn it off auto. Was around 1:30 a.m. And just, in other words,
I think we're almost done anyway.
And the water in the bathroom, there's still a decent bit. At nighttime,
right? Oh, I didn't know that. Actually, I haven't taken a shower yet.
She hasn't taken a shower yet.
You're no different. You smell like a big, fat, ugly donkey.
I'm not sure whether to take that as an insult or a compliment.
Insult.
Obviously.
So anyway, if Sayaka never touched the sword, then that means the killer is the only one who used the sword. But hold on. If that's right, then the one who damaged the sheath with the kitchen knife was...
The one who damaged the sheath would have had to have been the one without the sword. Was that the killer or Sayaka?
Sayaka.
You think it was Sayaka?
Tell me.
Do you think it was Sayaka?
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay, yeah.
Sayaka? She had the kitchen knife?
But we already said that the attack started with...
The person with the knife attacked first, and the sword was used as an impromptu defense.
Then the one who attacked first was...
Sayaka?
Now do you understand?
Yeah.
She wasn't a blameless victim in this.
No, far from it. It's almost as if she'd been planning to commit a murder of her own. She took the knife from the kitchen, then invited the culprit to the room she was staying in.
She was the most desperate of all of them.
And if it's true,
well,
that she had
from
the
our perspective, she seemed that way, but no one else showed themselves so blatantly to everyone, or to Makoto specifically.
Sayaka was the one who suggested you two switch rooms, correct? Maybe the reason she wanted to switch rooms was so that she could pin the crime on you. That is a possibility, is it not?
Yeah.
Sayaka wanted to... on me?
Haha, your girlfriend turns out to be a...
No, take kind of call that take earlier. That one line. Sayaka wanted to... on me? That can be used in so many contexts.
And by committing the murder, so you gotta feel bad for the person who actually did commit the murder.
But for that to work,
a sense.
Had to be lured out while still keeping the room swap a
secret. Just defending themselves.
If the target knew
were
she
they?
Had switched rooms, they would
well,
have
yeah.
become suspicious right away.
That's perfectly
so
adequate. You respond with what
names?
People...
With lethal force?
But they come at you with lethal force, risky. That is the legal definition of, so definition of self-defense. If they come at you with lethal
Mr.
force, you are allowed to do the same.
Rooms.
I don't know. I'm not sure our soft-hearted Makoto is capable of that kind of cutthroat behavior. I'm sure Sayaka realized the same thing, which is why, out of all of us, she asked him to switch rooms.
Plus, she was the ultimate pop sensation.
So, then,
Forgettable kid. Or a national superstar. Who are you more likely to believe?
What,
yeah.
Then?
He's feeling like an idiot, isn't he?
Planned out?
He's feeling pretty betrayed, probably.
But in the end, her plan backfired. She launched her attack with the knife, then found herself under attack in turn. That must be when her wrist got broken, and she was forced to drop the knife.
The tables were suddenly turned on her, and she died at the hands of the one she'd planned to murder.
Just hold on! That can't be true!
Dude,
because,
your girlfriend was gonna
because,
get you killed.
Hey! You guys have totally
derailed
the
argument. A lot
more
people killed than him.
You're being super boring right now. Come on, hurry up and decide who did it. Wouldn't it be awful if I had to punish you all just because you ran out of time?
Oh yeah, we gotta decide who we think did it.